Hello YouTubers, I just wanted to quickly introduce another project that I'm interested with, as it'll also help with my kind of research into what solar panel technologies work best. After doing the kind of solar powered go pack for my my little QRP ham radio, I decided it'd be very handy to put together a little solar power portable power pack for if I was going away for any electronic devices, whether it's a handheld ham radio, whether it's a cell phone, any electronic gadgets, or in fact laptops. And one comment which someone made on the solar powered go pack was a comment about using lead SLA sealed lead acid batteries and how heavy they were. So what I decided to do this time is put this little pack together with a 5-watt panel. The 5-watt panel, as per the other GoPack, simply velcros onto the top here. At the moment I've got it out in the sun. I need to adjust it because the angle of the sun has changed, but I've got a little WhatsApp meter just measuring what's coming in at the moment. You can see there's about just over 3 watts coming in. And I've resorted to using these little lithium power packs. I think the one's by Duracell and the one is by, I'll have to double check. But the beauty is this little lithium power pack has actually got a mains outlet, a 120 volt mains outlet, and 2 USB for charging. What it was lacking, which the reason I went for the second one, is it lacks any other DC outputs. Whereas this little lithium power pack has got USB outputs. It's then got a 9 to 12 volt output and a 16 to 20 volt output for laptops. So what I've done on the front, I've got two switches with an Anderson power pole. The Anderson power pole, I say, because I use Anderson power pole for most of my kits, so I can plug in my radio in there if need be, or any other devices. This one is the 9 to 12 volt output. I'm going to put another output for the any laptops. Then there's two switches, one to enable the panels to charge this little lithium power pack. And as you can see, it's busy, it's almost topped up at the moment. It takes about a day of sunlight to charge the one. And then what I can do, I can switch in and charge this power pack, and you can see that's charging as well. Or I can actually switch it off, so I can charge one at a time if I want the power to go to one. The beauty about this system is that you'll note there are no solar chargers here. And as I discovered, this this little lithium power pack requires, it comes with a 20 volt DC adapter to charge it. And the brilliant thing about that is that's about the power range that comes out of a solar panel. And in fact, it actually accepts, as you'll see at the moment, it's only getting about just shy of 16 volts. But it seems to be quite happy to work on a wide range of input voltage. But that means that it's almost acting as though you don't have to have a solar charge controller, because obviously the charge control electronics are inside. And where you normally have the power loss on a normal PWM solar charger, this is almost acting, giving you the benefits of an MPPT charge controller, as I've shown in a previous video, because it's allowing you to pull at the full voltage of your solar panel. So you actually get more watts coming in from your solar panel. Anyway, it's still a little project in progress. So I'm gonna still add a little a fan onto it. So at least you can actually have the box closed when you're charging it. I'll actually just bring the solar panel in at the moment, just so you can see a size comparison, because that's the other project, is seeing what solar panel technologies are doing. That's the ultimate reason I've been playing around. So just to put things in perspective, and this is something I've been doing with bigger panels, but unfortunately I haven't been able to get hold of some of the technologies that I want in the bigger panels. So this is a 5-watt polycrystalline panel, and the polys, as I've discovered, the polycrystalline panels work very well. You'll see behind it, and I'm just for size comparison, is a mono-crystalline. In my opinion, the mono-crystalline panels are the best. They give a far better output under low light conditions. And again, not shaded. There's a big difference. Shading means part of the panel is covered with shade. And for crystalline panels, that's a big no-no. You drop a lot of power on them, whereas the thin film amorphous or the SIGs, or known as GSE panels, if they're partially shaded, they still produce a lot of power. But I'll speak about them in a moment. So the the monocrystalline panels tend to be a little bit bigger in size. So that's why I've opted for a polycrystalline for this project, because if I pull the cover of the box over, you'll see it just fits nicely on the box, basically, and you can pull it off and put it out into the sun. The polycrystallines also tend to deliver better peak power, and when you've got your brightest sun conditions. But I think on average, depending on where you live around the world, on average, as say here in Ohio, Cleveland, Ohio, where you often get overcast conditions and it's and winter, you actually get better average output through a monocrystalline panel. But just for size comparison, if we go back to the mono, or the poly, I should say, this panel behind with the nice orange framing is an amorphous thin film panel, and you can see the size difference, and it's quite scary. They're a lot bigger. So this is a 5-watt panel, so is this. And to date, in my testing of this 5-watt and a 50-watt amorphous panel, they don't produce as much. They produce 30% less power on average than a crystalline panel. They are supposed to, and I mean, today is a fairly warm day. Under hot conditions, they're supposed to perform better. I have not seen that to date. I'm still testing, but I say, at the moment, I think the amorphous panels are a waste of time. My opinion, I'll be keen to see if anyone has any different information. And again, what I thought would be the be-all and end-all of solar panel technology is the SIGs, or the GSE thin film panels. This happens to be a six. It's very difficult to find the SIGs panels as solid framed panels. They often now produce them as flexible folding panels, is their biggest market. And they're supposed to be cheaper, but at the moment there's not many people producing them, so the technology is expensive. And it does not work. It works well under shaded conditions, which are the conditions you shouldn't be using your solar panels under. But under low light, the crystalline panels still perform far better. And again, size-wise, that is a 6-watt panel, and here is a 6-watt crystalline panel. And you can see there is a fair size difference, and cost difference as well. You can get crystalline panels now fairly cheap. If you're not buying a name brand Shell or BP or what have you, if you often the Chinese manufacturers, in fact, you can get, and they perform very well. Even though they tend to be cheaper panels, they actually, so far from the mix of panels that I've had, some of the cheaper ones have actually been have worked very well. I can't vouch for their longevity at all, but I say that I'll discover over time. But their build quality, I must say, seems to be fairly good. So anyway, that's a quick rundown. It's a project, a work in